size up. I don't think they big enough. Or the end of the sale, I'm thinking about Trey. I'm finna go.
Before today's video starts, please be sure to go in the description down below and check out MMOXP. They offer any amount of runes that you guys would like to purchase. They also offer any type of item that you would like in the game if you need it. They have cheap prices, they have fast delivery, and they have 24/7 support. And when you guys are checking out, make sure you do use code C2K for a 5% discount. Remember, the link is in the description down below. Enjoy the video. What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Charles C.K. coming back to you guys with another video. As you guys see from the title of the video today, we're going to be playing some more Elden Ring. And in this video, I'm going to show you guys how you can get an instant 100k runes very fast and very easy. But before I even do get started, make sure you guys do drop a like on this video and make sure you do go in the pinned comment down below and join my Discord. But without further ado, in order to do what I'm about to show you guys, you will have to make sure that you progress your way all the way to where I'm at right now, which is at the mountaintop of the giants. Now, if you guys don't know how to get to the mountaintop of the giant, I will leave a link of a video in my pinned comment down below explaining how you guys can get up here. But once you do get up here and you make your way all the way up here, there will be a boss battle up here and you guys will have the Foot of Forge like resting place to know that this is where you will be before the boss battle does start. And now once you guys are here, all you guys will simply do is follow the path that I'm taking right now and it will lead you directly into the boss battle with the fire giant. Now as soon as you guys get into this area, you will see his health bar will pop up, but if it's your first time here, you will get a cutscene. All you want to do is skip the cutscene and just run right up to him. Now as soon as you get like a little bit close, like almost like a footstep away from him, he will try to do an attack at you, so you do want to get off your horse and just make sure you dodge his attack. Also, once you dodge his attack, whatever attack it is, make sure you run between his legs. Now, once you guys run between his legs, you simply just want to take the path that I'm taking right now, which is, you know, you're just going to come all the way up, and it's towards like the right side. It will be right behind this little tree, the area that we're going to be using in order to do this. So basically, once you get him over here in this little area, you're going to jump up here on your horse. You're going to sit right here and wait for him to walk up on you and try to do an attack. And as soon as he does an attack, you guys are simply just going to do run and double jump in the area that I'm about to show you guys right now. So I'm just going to let you guys see him walk up on me, and this is exactly how you want to do it, so you guys do not mess up. Now, as you guys can see, he begins to attack, so I'm just going to run off and do a double jump, and you should land right here in this area. And when you guys are in this area for the first time, you want to simply get off your horse and come stand right here behind this rock like I'm doing right now. And the whole goal of this is to get him to, you know, jump down on you. So if he ever gets stuck, you just want to make sure you are redirecting him with your player. But once he gets, like, in that area that he's in right now, as you guys can see, he will do his charge up attack that, you know, kind of hits the ground. It should not hit you, but just to be very, very careful, make sure you do roll. Now, once he does that, he will then try to jump down on you. And as you guys can see, once he jumps down, he then will instantly die. Now, you will be prompted with a cutscene because he will be entering phase two. And don't worry, I will show you guys how you're going to beat phase two. So once he enters phase two, you want to go to the left side of the map like I'm doing right now. All the way along this little side, it will be blocked off. So you just want to follow this path that I'm taking right now. Also, make sure you do avoid his attacks because they are very, very powerful. If you do need any type of cover, you can just use this rock like I just did right there, and you will be completely fine. Now, once you guys have dodged his attack, you guys are simply just gonna go back to the same spot that we did the first time, which is right over here behind this little rock. Now, the only difference between the first phase and the second phase is you do not have to wait for him to get close. You do not have to wait for him to do an attack or anything. As you guys can see, I almost died. You just want to let him crawl like a little bit just so he sees you and he still has his attention on you. And once you've done that, you will just do the double jump and come stand right here in the area that I'm in right now. And once you guys begin to see his hand and he's creeping over like that, all you guys are going to do is move left and right constantly because he is kind of stuck and you just want to free him up. Now, in order to free him up, you do have to get off the horse. I had to notice that because if you're on the horse, he kind of does not react all the time. So make sure you are off the horse and you just simply want to stand like in this little area crevice, like where the hill is, as you guys see me doing right now. And basically it will make him creep up this whole little rock, and this is exactly what you guys want. Now as soon as he's all the way up there, you should be fine. He probably will do an attack or two and just fall down and die. And at this point, you guys have completely finished it. As you guys can see, he will then be dead, and that is completely all that there is to it. And once he is dead, all you have to do is accept all of this. And as you guys just saw, That is a free 180k runes. You can do this boss battle at any point of the game because you don't have to be in high level at all. All you guys have to do is follow the link in the description, that video, and get up here. So yeah, I hope you guys did enjoy this video. Don't forget to drop a like on this video. Don't forget to join my Discord. It has been your boy Charles 2K. I will catch you guys in the next one. I'm out. Peace.